In the last video, I discussed how it's necessary to carefully keep track of pre-planned news events, such as upcoming events, in order to create editorial content by tracking items that are scheduled and planned already, like an upcoming election, press conference, or musical event, for example. It's possible to write stories for the public previewing the event before it occurs, and then to report on the event as it actually does occur. One of the things I suggested was to look through the Pasadena Now calendar of events to pick out newsworthy events to be focused on. Here's an example on the screen from the editorial budget of May 28th to June 4th. This is a cocktail party to support Happy Birthday Pasadena. The article written before the event needs research in order to be written, and the article written to report on the event after it's occurred could also use that same research, as well as additional information, photographs, videos, and quotes from people during the event. But let's start now by talking about what needs to be done in order to write the preview article. I've copied this onto a separate page, so let's take a look over here. Here's the same information. In order to write any kind of an article based on this simple little blurb, a researcher has to dig into this and find out who, what, why, when, where, how, and all that sort of stuff. So it's a matter of analyzing the information and building on it. Obviously, you can see here the sponsor. In fact, there is the web address of the sponsor. You can see the topic is Happy Birthday Pasadena. We need to know what Happy Birthday Pasadena is. We also need to know more about the sponsor. Now let's read the copy. Special cocktail event. Come and join for cocktails. Okay. Photographs from the popular timeline will be available for viewing. I don't know what the timeline is, but we need to find out what the heck is this popular timeline. And when was the 2011 Happy Birthday celebration? What was that all about? What is El Portal? And that's probably, we get going on those things, we'll find out. We also need to find out the name or names of one or two people to discuss this story with. So let's see here. Let's take a look at the website. We need to get full information here. So I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but I am going to tell you that we do need to go through and find this event. Where is it? Here it is. Find out everything we can about it, because you can't write an article about it without this information. So the researcher takes the events information that we have before the event occurs and prepares a file or a dossier. Here's a lot more information. It's a free community celebration that commemorates Pasadena's 126th birthday on June 26th. Okay. So there's a lot of information here. It's on Wednesday, May 30th, right? El Portal Yucatan Mexican Restaurant, which we can look up. And here we go. Now here's a picture, too, for the City Hall cake in June 2010. So here's some information which definitely can be used to support the story. What else? We had Happy Birthday Pasadena, right? Let's see. Happy Birthday Pasadena. Let's just Google that phrase. Here's one. There's lots of information. Here's a story about it. Here's some old pictures about it. Here's a story from the Pasadena Weekly about it. Oh, there's tons of research information here. Not South Pass. We just want Pasadena. Oh, wow. It looks like it even has a Facebook page. Let's see here. I'm not sure, but let's check it out. Oh, this was the event in 2011. Okay. June 2011. Okay. So the bottom line is the researcher performs a lot of research by looking up all these keywords. And we're going to need to have a name of someone to talk to interview. So let's see here. I don't see any names on this. What I'm thinking is we would need to find the name of maybe the head of this museum to interview. Let's see, contact. So under contact or about, there's going to be the name of someone to talk to, would be my guess. We have to find out who at the museum James can speak with to discuss this event. And I would say look under contact or about and find the name of the president of the museum and any contact information so James can interview that person. So the bottom line is every item needs to have full research done with links and references so that the person writing the article previewing this event has enough information to actually write a story. Then we need to have a name of a person, because what will happen is this information goes back to James. James will call the person whose name is on this and say, tell me more about Happy Birthday Pasadena and the cocktail party you're having on Wednesday, May 30th. And that person will tell everything and will get a bunch of quotations and a whole lot more information. So the researcher, I think, really is the second step. First is identifying the stories. Second is researching the stories and being certain to get the name of someone to talk to. Third is James contacts the person to talk to and interviews them about this subject, thereby providing quotations and more information. And then the fourth step is to write a story, because by that time you've got the research and background information, you've got the interview with the key person that you can quote. I don't think you need anything else to write the preview story except what's there already. And then that information all is saved and kept on ice so that on the next day, on Thursday, May 31st, the news writer now will be given everything he had to produce the preview story earlier in the week. Plus now, the writer will be given quotations and of interviews conducted during the actual event on the May 30th, and we'll take a look at video clips and photographs from the event in order to describe the actual event. So that's the procedure and process that I envision, but it does require a researcher digging deep and doing all this research, including the name of someone to interview, and then the whole thing has to go back to James, because James has got to pick up the phone and call one or two people and interview them about the event, get their remarks on tape, and then that is what gets sent to the writer to write the preview article. And the preview article should be published about 3 or 4 days minimum before the event, so the public knows about it and knows what will be happening. And then James will actually go to the actual event itself, take photographs, video of the events, and interview more people in person during the event, and turn those in to the writer, who will then write a report on what actually happened, what was said, what was done, who was there during the actual cocktail party on May 30th, and that'll be the follow-up story. This, in general, is the procedure that follows identification of pre-planned news events and comes before interviewing key people associated with pre-planned news events.